Hi, this is Milan Shalvi. In this episode, I'll show you how to cast shadows from your original video over text added in LumaFusion in post. For this effect, choose footage that is still, with no shakes or sudden movements. The subjects in your video should cast relatively long shadows. Those shadows should be significantly darker than the color of the surface where they are projected. The text will be placed over the area where the shadows are cast. Make sure that other than the shadows, this area remains free of interferences for the duration of the time that the text is shown on screen. Here's the footage that we'll be using for this tutorial. And here is how the final result will look with the effect applied. Let's start by creating the 3D text over which the shadows will be cast. The text for this tutorial will be created using the Fonto app, but it can be created in other apps such as Affinity Photo. We start with a new LumaFusion project already containing the video with the shadows that we'll be using for this tutorial. Move the timeline to the position where you want the text to start showing. In my case, this is right at the beginning of the video. Take a snapshot. Now, in Fonto, open a new 16:9 black plane image. Add the snapshot that you just exported from LumaFusion and resize it to fit the screen. Next, add your text. I recommend keeping the text short. Use the default white face color and a font of your choice. Bolder fonts will look better because they have a bigger area where the shadows can be cast. Also, align the text to the center. Resize and move the text so it is positioned where the shadows are. Using the 3D tool, adjust the perspective so it looks as if the text is resting flat on the surface. Notice that in Fonto, the 3D tool is part of the text style kit and requires a one-time purchase. Once you're satisfied with the result, remove the image. Export the image of the white 3D text over the black background. Now, back in LumaFusion, add the image with the text exported from Fonto just above the video in the main track. Adjust the start time and duration as needed. For this tutorial, the text will show for the entire duration of the video below it. Now, let's start making the text look as if it was painted on the floor. Edit the image with the text and set the blend mode to screen. Reduce the opacity to about 65%. Add the Gaussian 5 preset and reduce the radius to 1. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks so far. Now it's time to make the shadows look as if they were cast over the text. Duplicate the clip on the main track, it will be automatically placed on the third track. Edit the video that you've just duplicated. Reduce the opacity to about 70%. Add the LumaKey preset. Make sure that the reverse key option is selected. Set roll-off, erosion distance, and edge blur radius to 0. Now adjust the luma range so the shadows look as if they were cast over the text. This will also add some texture to the text, which will help make it look as if it was part of the surface where it is positioned. Exit back to the timeline, and we are done. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you are notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.